Well, we're back live, friends. Sorry, we had like a lag spike or something. I don't know. Life gives me lemons. I make lemonade. I never let a little technical difficulty get to me. Got nothing but time to hang out and stream with you amazing people. Yeah. I do apologize, though, for the interruption.
We never like to see an interruption.
Alright, I have a feeling we're going to be awesome right now. It's going to be like, yeah, take them down, team.
Go, team, go.
Alright, I'm bringing thermite again. See, I thought I had my thermite set up with a breaching charge on him, too. But apparently I think I have flashbangs on them now, so I guess I must have thought, well, I only need the one thing, the thermite charge, but I thought I had a breaching charge on them. I'll have to check.
I'll have to check.
Ah, nice. It is a crucial element. We got a guy short at the start, it looks like. Doesn't mean anything, though. Good team could make up for the loss of one guy. Well, it looks like they're down below. I watched the best movie yesterday. Have you ever seen The 100-Foot Journey, Moonrake? It's a great movie, especially if you like chefing and cooking and French food. And yeah, whatever. They wasted five clips to get me. Wasted five clips to get me. All right. Hey, thanks, Dan. Really appreciate you subbing back to us, bro. You know, always no pressure or anything like that. It means a lot. The channel can't stay on the air without you. But we do appreciate it, man. You subs, you help us hang in there and keep strong. Time for some ears. Take back. Yes, yes, Moonrake. I know I cut through an odd thermite door. Whatever, I wanted to make a big impression. Enemy detected outside. These guys are ambitious. Oh, I shot him 30-20 times, man. Oh, Psycho Boy Jeff, we always appreciate it. Down to one friend. Mom's strong, you know. She had to decide whether she wanted to live or die, you know. That's just what it is. Alcoholism is a... See, I got an assist on that. Alcoholism is a tough disease. What's up, Afro Soap? Stream Metal, hello! Look, guys, we got Moonrake here visiting. Moonrake, give a wave. Woo, do the wave. Yeah! Moonrake. Oh. What sounds good to eat today, friend? Where should we go? Mongolian barbecue? You want Mongolian barbecue? You shit your pants 5 days. Maybe we'll go over to the 333. It's my friend's restaurant. That's amazing. I didn't want to get blown away. I wanted to live. I do appreciate the sentiment on my mom. Guys, I'm really strong, though. Like, I know that at the end of the day, I'm only responsible to live my own life. And, you know, it does stress me out seeing my mom go through self-destructive behavior. But what I take from it is, you know, don't quit. You can always get better. You can always improve. And, yeah, man, as far as I'm doing, I'm psychologically strong. You know, it hurts. It gets to me. You know, it's sad to see a family member just be so captured by alcohol, but that's their life, you know. The only life I can live is my own. That is Moonrake. If I had a son, that would be my son. I see that pack of cigarettes next to him. It makes me want to beat him right now. Like, what? You're not allowed to smoke, Moonrake.
Done with the wire. The hostage location is compromised. Get ready.
When I was your age, I used to love cigarettes, dude, because it, like, made me look like an adult. Actually, I was younger than you. I was, like 21. And my Uncle Tim would always be like, don't stick little skinny things between your lips and make fun of me. But, it helped because I was like, I want to look cool for Uncle Tim. So I never really got into smoking. He used to make fun of me, man. No way, bro. I got my shield of doom here in my own little, like, secret spot. Yeah. I like it when they breach me through the left. Ow! He's breaching me through the left! Moonrake's prophecy has come true! Hey, it works for them, might work for me. Ah, there you go. When in doubt, let your teammate take them all out. He's going over by the wall of... Oh, don't get into the back! Why does it look like one guy's shooting one way and the other guy's shooting the other? I'm gonna come in here and sit with this guy. Try to go prone right in front of the hostage, right when they start firing, just move out of the way. It's like, what?
Deploying sensor.
But they got that guy that shoots those arrows, sets us on fire and stuff. Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's badass. Those new operators are beast mode. So is the girl. She's badass, too. Kadera's badass. What happened to the last stream? Who knows? Aurora Borealis, my friend. Aurora Borealis. Yay! Woo! I know, all I did was put up some armored walls. Hey, I did my job. I was the last line of defense. Oh, man. All right, I'll breed thermite again. Yeah, but who knows, bro? Lag spike, you know, solar radiation, anything could knock out the stream. We do apologize for the interruption. The Mongolians. You want Mongolian beef, boys? It's delicious. It's not delicious. It make you shit yourself for 5 days. Moonrake and me were watching South Park videos. Oh. I gotta play that game Stick of Truth sometime, man. I hear it's hilarious. I'm a huge South Park fan. I started watching South Park about 99, maybe a little earlier than that, 98. Yeah, they are. I'm trying to find the downstairs, bro. I'm, like, lost, bro. Left this way? Dude, these guys are breaking stuff up. Oh, nice. Oh, yeah, you can just kick through it? I thought you had to have like Sledge's sledgehammer or something. Copy that. He shot my cankle off! What's up, Bloodface Pig? Defense is the best offense? I thought I dropped that guy. I did drop him, but he managed to kill me as I dropped him, dude. You don't drink coffee? Yeah, alright, don't drink it then. It's good. Steve, hello, sir! Bogey over there. There you go. Oh, and you got a bogey. You opened the door for the bogey to shoot you in the face. The poor guy. He opened the door and the other guy, he saw the one guy, but he breached this way and there was a guy behind the way he breached. This guy's, it's the man with the golden gun. Oh. What? Oh, for the game? I thought you meant in real life. I was like, what kind of gold, eh? We'll get into that business. I want a gold magnum. What do I think of the new Deus Ex? I think the game's pretty awesome.
Hoss is located.
Just saw him. You caught him peeking. Nice, you got them all turned around. Good stuff. Get that hostage. Oh man, he had him. Oh yeah, I think the new Deus Ex is good, bud. I would give it a solid, like, 9 out of 10. And if you're a fan of the series, a 10 out of 10. You know, great gameplay, intuitive. It's a great game. I've been playing it the last couple days in the broadcast. I played it yesterday, and I played it Actually, I think I played it the day before. Is that, like, the day after tomorrow's the day before? Rex looking at me like, no. Alright, we're going to do this. I got a feeling of goodness. I believe. We got Pepe Salazar here to throw down. Yes, Moonrake. Dan Lee says hello to you. Moon's hungry, Dan. He's pacing around in my kitchen going, feed me or feed me to something. He knows that we're going to go for some chicken fried steaks and ice-cold, delicious, frosty beer. I got a place around the corner, literally around the corner, that makes the amazing chicken fried steak. They do such a good job.
Down to 5 seconds.
What? We got a T'Chaka. T'Chaka. Doesn't bother me. I ain't your daddy. Drink whatever you want. You're adult. I just won't let you drive. That's the one thing I will do. He'll be like, I want to go driving. I'll be like, jump kick. See him fly out the window. Ah! That's the cool thing about the spot I got around the corner. Walking distance, bro. I always walk down there, especially because I drink like 20 beers when I'm down there. I come back, I'm like, there's a weird part of Costa Mesa over there. I like watching YouTubes when I come off to see what, like, oh, nice. There's a Costa Mesa lets people buy the sidewalk in some areas. So literally you'll be walking down the sidewalk and you just come to a fence and you got to walk out of the street. I'm like, what the f-? That must be hard on rollerbladers. When I was a kid, when I was a young adult, probably like 20, maybe 21. Yeah, I was 21. I was old enough to drink. I was walking down the boardwalk. It was New Year's Eve. And a guy went flying by me on a bike, drunk as crap, dude. I'm like, dude, that guy's going to crash into somebody on the boardwalk and hurt him. Dude, less than a half mile down the road, I'm coming down the road, and the guy's just sitting there, and he's got a freaking piece of fence, wrought iron fence, sticking through his shoulder. He's like, hey, bro, can you call an ambulance for me? I'm like, dude, you've got a fence sticking through your arm, bro. He's like, yeah, I crashed my bike and landed on this guy's fence. Dude, it was gnarly. They had to cut the fence off with a welding torch, dude. It was brutal. Damn robot. I raced all my ammo shooting robots. They buy a robot. Look at this. I'm going to be the people under the stairs. That movie always scared me when I was a kid, dude. I was like, I don't want to wind up in somebody's basement. Oh, look, they're coming through the roof right there. Sneaky, sneaky. I didn't even know you could come through the roof right there. Ah, I can't move! Moonrack, save me! Ha ha! Save myself, Moonrack! Don't need you for anything! Ow, they're on the other stairs! Teammate, shoot that guy! No, don't let him finish me! No! My teammate's sitting there looking at the guy shooting me. What are you watching that stairwell for? Jeez, they didn't got blown up with a hand grenade. Hey, welcome to the stream, everybody. I'm hanging with one of my best friends, Young Moonrack here. We're just joking around, talking about things in life. He came down to go fishing the night before with my dad. So, Moon, how was the overall experience on the Don Juan? What did you think of the boat? It is. It's nice. 77-foot Hatteras sport fishing yacht. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
10 seconds left.
Oh yeah, the Don Juan often leads the Christmas parade. It, like, if you want, you should come down like the 18th of December, and it's a little cool. So you dress a little warm, but you travel around on the Don Juan in the Christmas parade. It's all lit up.
Mission failed. Op 4 extracted the hostage.
John, the owner, is a legend in Newport. I mean, he's been kicking ass in that town for 50 years. So. You know, he's a member of the Tuna Club, the Rotary. He's awesome, man. He's a great guy. He often hires me to do catering. Like, his house is amazing, not just the boat, but if I go over and... his house is amazing, but he does a party every Super Bowl. He always hires me and has me do all the stuff, dial it in. It's nice. It's always like I can count on like $3,000 from John like every Super Bowl. Then the last couple times I've won the pot there, which is pretty cool. Yeah. We do it by quarters. I've literally won two of the quarters in the same night. Yeah, I've won two of the quarters in the same night. $20, you put down $20 on a square that you want, and then, you know, it's a first-come, first-served basis, so I always take the... I'm like, yep, that looks like that'll be the final score, that'll be the middle score, and... Oh, yeah. 13 never comes up. Dude, we had one a couple years ago, man, and like it ended at like 34 points, and I was like, really? Right where my, I got that? Yay! I won two that night, and my dad won one, and the people were like, the Eulers are cheaters! Oh. That's pretty rad. A couple years ago in Vegas, man, at the sports book, dude, I did pretty good on betting on the Vikings, dude. They went down there and it was like 10 to 1 odds. And I was like, ah, what the hell, you know, Vikings, Patriots, let's go. Oh, man. Oh, good stuff. It's like my buddy, when I was back in the day betting on Dallas, and my buddy's like, Buffalo will do it this year. Buffalo's going to do it this year. I'm like, yeah, all right. She said last year. Oh, it's like Jim Kelly's got it. They just got one of their most... LeBron James brought the first championship back to Cleveland since the 50s, since Jim Brown was there with the Cleveland Browns.
We need to protect the biohazard container. Secure the room.
Wall is reinforced!
Op 4 drone has found the biohazard container.
Oh, San Diego. I believe it translates to a whale's vagina. You don't know.
10 seconds to insertion.
Half those plates around.
5 seconds to insertion.
I know, I always die first, Lady Valkyrie. It's not fair.
Op 4 has located the biohazard.
The only reason I'm dying first is because Moonrake's in my living room and not in the game with me. Brave teammate. I should put the camera out there, man.
Nice role play.
Oh, sneaky. Sneaky, sneaky little Valkyrie. Learning to fly. I've been learning to shoot toes off. I'm like, this little piggy went to the market. This little piggy went wee, wee, wee all the way home. Dude, the other day I tried to shoot a guy through the door. I blew out the hole and he shot me back in the face through the hole I shot out, dude. See my smiling face looking like a jack-o'-lantern. I've learned to crawl past these windows. I'm always afraid of Glaz. Right over where he's at. Dude, the first time I was playing this game, I like laid down and looked and a guy broke a hole through the wall right next to me and like had his shotgun sticking through there. He shoots my teammate in the face and then I took him out, dude. I was like, I can do that. No, Bleach, I really haven't played too much 7 Days to Die. I tried it one time. It's a cool game. It's hard for me to get into building games. But I like it. I like what it's about.
One op four remaining.
I like what it's about. Zombie survival's pretty awesome. I am enjoying Deus Ex. That game is amazing. Deus Ex is great. Yeah, Deus Ex Mankind Divided is... Yeah, that's why I'm not rushing nothing. This guy, he just got shot. Nice! Yeah! Hyper teabag dance! See, it was a good thing I moved from that wall over there. My own teammate probably would have blown me away. Play State of Decay? Yeah, I played it before a few times. They actually visited us. Undead Labs, the guys that made State of Decay, they actually came by the stream when I was playing it. They were like, hold open the car door right now. And I held open the car door and hit a zombie in the face and got an achievement. They're like, you're welcome. They were pretty cool. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the second one, man. The sequel. I hear it's going to be cooperative. I enjoy State of Decay, though. An interesting thing about it is I believe that it was a pet project of one of the creators of Warcraft, and like they actually started up Undead Labs because he wanted a zombie-style game. It might not have been Warcraft, though. It might have been the guy that did... Dude, I have been petitioning Xbox recently for an Everest simulator. I want to see, you know, VR and let me climb Mount Everest. I think that would be awesome. All right, dear blood, but welcome back. Glad to have you here, bro.
Good work. The biohazard container
has Oh, they shot me right when I found the thing. Coffee Sage got the...
Insertion in 10 seconds. 5 seconds to insertion.
Yeah, I can definitely cut that one open. Moonrake's backseat gaming. Moonrake! So shh, Moonrake, the captain always knows which way to sail the ship. Not Blackbeard the Pirate, you called it. You called it. Oh, what? Ah! Oh, hey, watch out for that! I'm kind of through there. James Bond! Ow, he's got a friend! How many bullets can that guy take? Some food in my inventory, always some fall. I thought I got him, but his buddy had a machine gun. Damn it. Those guys are bullet resistant, man. They're like, oh, you only shot me 13 times. It takes 14. It takes 14 to kill me. Yeah, I don't play 7 Days to Die. Like, I don't have it installed, but I mean, I'm sure there's somebody that probably plays it around here or something. Alright, so you got two of them spotted, guy. Probably go a lot better if our one guy wasn't busy. wasn't getting shot in the rump roast. Oh man, this guy's making me dizzy, dude. Look at this guy down there just hovering off. Oh man. Ascend Karmaz, I don't have anybody in here right now. I just have my team mates of randomness.
Don't dance with him. Don't shoot your own guy. Do something, right, wrong, or different.
He's laying on the package, man.
Securing the loom. 10 seconds. One friendly operator remaining. 5 seconds left.
Oh, we're out of time. What's he gonna do? Scooch his way in there? Oh, man. That was funny. Okay, here's my sub lead. Here's my sub link in my YouTube. Oh, man. Alright, I think we're gonna make it this time, Sarge. I'm bringing out T'Chunka. No, I'm gonna live! Rex is like, you're gonna die!
No, I'm gonna live, Moonrag.
Secure the room. We need to protect the biohazard container.
Moonrag. I live to win. Live to win till Chef dies, till a virtual bullet flies through my eye. Oh, man. Get shot right in the nads by glass standing there.
5 seconds left. Op 4 has located the biohazard container.
I'll let him locate some of this. Locate the T'Chunka. I know, they're come right up and just be very, very quiet. I'm hunting rabbits right now. Come to Butthead.
Sensor activated.
No, that's what I hate hearing when I'm set up over here. Watch those windows. Ow! Not my cankle! Ah! He's got backup! Danley, do you have any storage containers to store resources in? I find organizing my stuff helps keep track of things. Look at Dan Lee giving the good tips! Dan the Man Lee! Hey, Dan. Resident Evil 4, man. I'm excited, bro. I was going back through my brain, and I was like cycling like thousands and thousands of game hours in my brain, remembering like the fight with Krauser in Chapter 5, and like remembering like the first town, and how I like to throw down in that first town, because that first town, when you have to stand up and survive, can be a challenge. And then that second time, when you have to survive in that house, and they're coming up all the stairs and stuff. I was going back to my tactics and my brain pie. I'm excited. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna die, dude. I'm gonna die like so. You're gonna die, clown! The frisbee turret? Yes, the Bren gun. I'm really excited for 4, though, bro. I was thinking about the crown that you get in Chapter 4, and you get the gems for the crown between like Chapter 3 and 2, and if you sell the crown without the gems, it's like 10,000 gold, but if you put the gems in it, it's like 25,000 gold. I remember where the pipe in the tree is, all sorts of stuff. Yeah, it does sound like there. Yep, there's a guy chasing me. Don't leave me, I leave the cater alone! Ah! Ha 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 ha! You can't hit me, I'm the gingerbread man! Yeah, waste your ammo! Oh yeah, that is a brutal one, bro. And also, You remember that monster before the Krauser fight, the monster at the end of Chapter 4 that you can't kill when you have to sneak through the suspended cages? Oh, brother, I haven't done that since like 2004, and I can still remember that, dude. That doesn't sound good. Waiting for him to blow his breach charge. Hell yeah. That's how I roll. I got one eye. Yeah, booby traps. Shot through my own guy's legs. That's how I roll. She is badass. Did you see that two shot with the pistol? I want that
gun. I think she's gonna be the third one I get, though, damn it.
Alright. Time to get this coffee. Needs to be refreshed.
It needs a refreshment.
It needs a refreshing.
Guys, I don't send out invites. I'm a pro streamer here with Twitch. Don't, if you're not on my friends list, it's not going to happen. So please don't spam it into my broadcast. And if you're not a troll and you seriously want to invite, a proper way to do it is to whisper chat any requests. Don't just start putting it in the stream. Otherwise, I just think you're a troll, you know? So thank you. Here, let me respond. There you go. But nobody's ever told me no before. Well, I'm telling you no. I'm a pro streamer. I get paid to do this. If you can't understand it, there's lots of channels where you can go ask the pro streamers to stop streaming, but I'm not gonna. Thank you. Have a nice day. Wow, it's not angry. It's the same guy making 100 pro accounts. Can I play? Can I play? Can I play? No, I'm not stopping my broadcast to send invites. If they can't respect it, I don't care. You know, that's it. Well, that's bullshit. That's what separates pros like myself from guys that want to be streamers and dudes that get paid to stream. Because the guys that get paid to stream, we don't stop our streams. We know the stream is the most important thing. Not somebody that goes, can I play? Oh, wait, I can't join. Send me a party invite. Wait, I can't. That didn't work. Join mine. And then before you know it, your broadcast has been paused for a half hour and it dies anyway. So you know what? There it is. I just start booting them. I know. I'm just telling you, Steve. It's like it's ridiculous. You know, I'm in a 5-series game, and it's like, hey, send me an invite. Yo, invite.
Reinforced wall.
Why? What? I cussed? That's Moonrag doing all the cussing. He's like, screw this, and to hell with that. Moonrag, your language. Located the biohazard. Excuse me. I did. Oh, where Captain tells him not to cuss. Did you really just tell me language? This guy dancing back and forth. It's like Lady Valkyrie drones over here. I hate them. These drones are too good. Don't sass what our team does and does not have. I'm doing great. I'm living large. I'm living the dream. I got Moonrack with me. Nothing like having Moonrite come hang out. I wanted you to catch a fish, bro. I was going to make a pokey with it. I was all excited. It's like, bring me the bluefin tuna.
We did see that great white, though.
What? You saw a great white? Oh, that's rad. That's rad, bro, Hammy. Oh, yeah.
Op 4 is securing the container.
Yeah, there's nothing like going whale watching on the Don Juan. That's a great boat for whale watching. Dude, wait a minute. They're already in there capping this thing? I don't know. Steve, at the end of the day, I don't stop streaming, you know? It's not even that. It's the same guy that the only thing that ever ties up my stream is request to play. That's why many times I've contemplated only played single-player games. At the end of the day, I don't stop my stream. That's why I'm a Twitch partner getting paid and why guys that are like, oh, if somebody makes a request, I try to track it down. Last year, what I learned very hard was when I had a stream of 1,000 people and I got a guy like, please let me play Zombie Army Apocalypse. Please let me play Zombie Army Apocalypse. I send him an invite. Oh, no, I can't join. 10 minutes goes by. 15 minutes goes by. It's a joke. Lady Valkyrie, I love you. I will invite you. I need to be protected. That's right. Oh, I tell you, man. It's like... Ooh.
Do you know who I am? Find the biohazard container location.
Everybody's important, you know, and I care about everybody in the stream. It's not even like that. It's just that there's sometimes that invites go out, you know.
Nicely done. The biohazard container has been located.
I don't know, I have a super secret ability here to drive past doors. They're in like the laundry room back here or something.
5 seconds before insertion.
I want to get to that part of the house. You are important too, Nemesis Fiddlin. You're all important. Hello, Dark Angel Babe. What's that? Oh, then he just... Nice! Sneaky, sneaky little mute. Sneaky, sneaky little mute. Oh, come on, man! I was throwing out my mighty camera. Yeah, it's always is what it is, Steve. You know, at the end of the day, the thing that makes me laugh is I get these like, invite me, I want to play. But when I'm not streaming and I'm playing the same game, those people never ask me for invites. So the reality of it is something about the stream's attention and stuff like that, and that I need to cater to it at that moment. And I don't stop the streams anymore because of that, because I've learned better over time. Java, hello! That's right, they were inspired by my death. They're like, they killed Chef! Vengeance!
One friendly operator remaining.
That's right, they're like, Chef's dead! Marauders! Shut up, Lady Valkyrie! Chef dead first, I'm so surprised. My death galvanized my team, and that stun grenade I got off right as I died, they were like, Chef stunning them! Charge! Quick, kick him in the corpse nuts! That reminds me of Monster Squad. Kick Wolfman in the nards! Wolfman don't have nards! And he kicks him in the nuts and he goes, damn, Wolfman have nards!
We need to protect the biohazard container. Time to armor up.
Every movie scarred you for life when you were a kid. You know what movie that got me like that was Silence of the Lambs, man. We were just young bucks, and we decide we're going to sneak into an R-rated movie. And my buddy's like, dude, let's sneak into Silence of the Lambs. And I'm like, that movie, I don't know. By the end of that movie, I was traumatized. Dude, the one that scared me more than Gremlins was the movie, when they did, the remake of the thing was pretty good, and the original thing was pretty good. Aliens got me really good, but, oh, come on, man! I know I missed him, but I'm just saying, that wasn't fair. I got robbed. It'd only be fair if I was some
biohazard container. Intervene immediately. Friendly, last operator standing. Prevent further access to the biohazard container. Op 4 is securing the container. All friendlies were eliminated. Mission failure.
What's happening, Almond Pilot? Hello to you.
Locate the biohazard container.
October 25th for the new Dark Souls DLC. I know. Oh, dude, that RoboCop movie was harsh, man. Dude, when that guy got melted by the toxic waste, that freaked me out. I was like 40, dude, and I was like, oh my god, the toxic waste is melting its face off.
The biohazard container location.
The abandoned? Oh, okay, yeah. Well, I brought sledge this time anyways. Since they shut up. Now I'm going with hand grenades this time. I'm gonna charge it through the front door and hand grenade him in the face. Well, this guy's got the same idea. Thank you. Donkey. Ah!
Resume securing the container once the threat is neutralized.
Well, it is the area from Dark Souls 1, the painted world. Wait, reminds me of the DLC from Dark Souls 2, only much darker. Okay, so the painted world of Aramis, I remember that because I had an amazing duel in that world. Uh-oh.
One friendly operator remaining. Op 4 eliminated. Friendly mission successful. Locate the biohazard container. Well done. Biohazard container located.
Oh, my mic's off. Nice. I had it off on purpose. I was chastising Moonrag. Oh. That's funny.
Or did you just remute it?
No, I know. Oh, I have it unmuted now.
Yeah.
No, I know. I'm not muted anymore. I've read what he told me. I was muted until that time. All right.
He's probably on his phone.
What happened?
I can sign into my phone and you won't see me online either.
What happened? If you sign in with your phone, it doesn't show you online?
No. Hmm. And you can watch Twitch through your phone.
So? All right. All right. Well, I sent out a couple invites, Lady V. I invited a couple operators here. Smooth operator. I invited you and Nemesis Fidlet. Hey Steve, your gamer tag's Cadillac, bro. I didn't see it in my thing a second ago. I remember your Cadillac 86. The nurses? Oh my god, in Silent Hill, the game, in the original Silent Hill, when people tell me, what do you think was the scariest game you ever played? Silent Hill, the original. The nurses with... Well, there were a couple set in asylums. Oh, you're talking about, Oh, I thought that was on this one. I didn't play that one. You're talking about Outlast or something like that, or? I did think I didn't buy. There was a game, definitely Silent Hill. Definitely Silent Hill. What's happening, Aaron? How you doing? Dead Space, the original Dead Space was pretty scary.
Fear was not scary at all.
Fear, I didn't find scary, but I found Fear interesting. I liked it. I liked the game a lot. I liked the time slow mechanic. I found Dead Space 2, I thought, was a lot scarier than 1. You start out in a straitjacket, and you're like, gotta run for your life at the start. That was intense. Silent Hill 2 didn't really scare me that much because having gone to Silent Hill in 1, the first one scared me because it was different. Like Resident Evil, the enemies were tangible, but in Silent Hill, the enemies could come out of the fog at you, and so you had that limited ammo feel where you didn't feel like you had enough ammo. Yeah, Fear was amazing. Steve, your gamer tag's Cadillac, bro? I was looking for it a second ago. I didn't see it. Well, yeah. Yeah, it's interesting, the mix. I hear there's going to be another set of operators from Japan. Are you excited for Ghost Recon Wildlands? You can go to the store and pre-order it already. There's a... If you do... No, if you click on it, though, you can see conceptual video, like some vids from that they've shared out. So you don't have to buy it, but you can see some early, you know, things for the game. Well, Mass Effect's backwards compatible, but the other two, Why did my own guy just shoot me?
Bomb located by Op 4.
Let's fix that, shall we?
Lady Valkyrie blasted the guy that blasted me. That's funny. All great, Valkyrie. Now they're going to be all butthurt next round, our own team. Oh no, now the Wookiee shot Valkyrie. Then he came back and shot me. Oh man. Yeah. That's never fun. What? Rose is here? Hi, Rose! You know, they're remaking The Ring. It looks pretty scary. Yeah, they're remaking it. Just saw a trailer for it the other day on Twitter.
We need to locate a bomb.
Oh, they voted to kick me? Trolls. I could take my archive video from this and send it over to the guys over at Rainbow. Be like, this is what guys are doing in your game. Team killing and kicking you before the match even starts. All the videos recorded on here, so I have digital proof of exactly what happened. I can send it straight over to a moderation team. It's do I want to waste my breath? Don't let it bother you, Valkyrie. You can't teach good behavior to, you know, people that don't want to behave. Yeah, you know, you can't make people social. Some people just don't have social skills. I'll send you another invite. I know that's another thing that's stressful is, you know, people go, oh, send me an invite. Then they're not appearing online, so I got to go through 600 people down the run. It's frustrating. You don't watch horror movies, Steve? I watch a lot of them. Dude that cheated and then booted me was O Wookie. Yeah, I believe me, bro. I've dealt with this for so long on here. If I go through my messages from Xbox, bro, if I go through my messages from Xbox Live, it's like, thank you for making Xbox Live a safer place, like every other message on there. Because if people mess with me and I report them, they get 86 so fast. Nah, I'm going to go with Fuse. Hey, I got Lady Valkyrie here. That's all that matters. Never been a fan of horror movies. I like them. Oh, my God. You know, that's the one thing that... Woo! I love being follically challenged. I remember my grandma took us all for buzz cuts when we were kids. And... my sister got lice like a day later. We were living in Hawaii and she got lice. And I was the only one in the house that didn't get it. Yeah, buzz cut. I've never had lice in my entire life. The one benefit about being bald. That's my grandma. My grandma would pay us to shave our heads because my cousins would always grow long hair. So if we went to my grandma's for the summer, she would pay us to shave our heads. I started growing a mullet just to get paid by grandma. My grandma always liked like that 50s look, like high and tight. Nice job. I'm gonna go up and stick one of these things on this window right here. What the hell? I went all the way up to the roof up here. I only wanted to be up to here. That guy took a lot of bullets, dude. That guy took a lot of bullets, man. Oh, he can't. Whoa. Is that my own guy? That's an enemy?
Four last operator standing. Stop.
Ah, he came out through the window. I should have known better. No, Oh, dude, I don't even give those guys any kind of credence. They're not like cartoon characters to me, Steve. No reality. What do you mean? Oh, to character Twitch? I was like, yeah, I think I tried Twitch. Remute this time. My one character with a shotgun. My one character with a shotgun!
We need to protect the biohazard container. Secure the room.
I want to go out that way!
Op 4 drone has found the biohazard container.
Yeah, no, buzz cut's definitely not effective for the ladies.
Insertion. Op 4 has located the biohazard container.
The other day I had mine sitting in that chair right there for like 5 minutes, dude. I kept catching them. This way? Dude, one time I was sitting right here, and a guy did his fuse blast through there. I got a couple shots on him. I hit him a couple times. All right, man. I love that game, Dan. I love XCOM. Such a good game. Oh, ow! Oh! Happy birthday! I can't believe that worked. I was inspired by Lady Valkyrie. That guy got a mouthful of buckshot. Up, look, oh, look, he responded. Shut up, Moonrake. Lightning sometimes strikes twice. Ow! Oh, I hit that guy with the first shot. I saw blood spray. No. That's awesome, Dan. I love that game. XCOM's a great game. XCOM 2, no, we should see it. Yeah, you know, I think it did have a September release. I think it's gotten pushed back to October now. Maybe. We should see it, though, this year. See, what happened with XCOM 2 that a lot of us wondered about is they launched it last year only on PC, and all of us were like, what? We want it on console. Please. Please bring it to console. Oh, hey, I got him. I marked him. There he is, guys. There he is. Alright, good job, team. Yeah, I think it did get pushed back. It'll be out. They probably pushed it back from the 13th, Dan, because that's the day that ReCore's launching. And they probably didn't want to go up against ReCore. You know, ReCore's got a lot of good publicity right now. It's also got a $39 price tag. So launching on a day when there are no games as compared to a big game is probably going to help their sales.
Well done. Biohazard container located.
Good job, team.
Insertion in 10 seconds. 5 seconds to insertion. Proceed to biohazard container location.
All right, let's do it.
Here we go.
Off the roof.
No! 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 Those bastards killed Sheffy! Much fun. All right, I'm to Chunk-a-late in this bad boy. You know, I haven't played the newer one. I played the first one, XCOM Enemy Unknown, but I haven't played Enemy Within yet. I downloaded it. It looks amazing. All right, we're going to do it. We got this, Lady V.
We need to protect the biohazard container. Secure the room.
Let's get him, Lady V. Valkyrie or victory, one way or another, there will be death to the enemy. Where's the container at? Right here. All right, I'm gonna set up because they're gonna come right through that door. They're gonna be like, "What's up?" I'll be like, "What's up, E?"
10 seconds left. Down to 5 seconds. Off-board drone has located the biohazard container.
I know, I gotta get more into Halo. I've only played like the first two levels on it, on Halo 5. Been missing out on that one. Alright, come to Butthead.
Deploying heartbeat sensor.
Yeah, what's up, Lady V? Don't get your head in the middle of my gun range.
Deploying heartbeat sensor.
Oh,
Whoa, what the hell happened? Oh, my gun disappeared. I've never seen that happen before. I've never seen T'Chunka's gun disappear like that before. That's not good.
One friendly remaining.
Ah, son of a
failed. All friendly.
Sorry. Tyler Smith, welcome back. I never seen T'Chunka's gun disappear like that before. That was crazy. Yeah, a little bit about XCOM 2. Definitely. Have a good one, Stream Metal, sir!
Find the biohazard container location. Good work. The biohazard container has been located.
Get these guys, I can feel it. Our team's got like this badass, like kick-ass feel going to it. Oh, no, don't fall off that! Ow, my cankles! Ow! I fell, and I can't get up. Life alert. Life alert! Thank you! Sat in my spot. No. Oh, why? Moonrack, they blew me away. Shut up, Moonrack. They shot me in my specials. Yeah, temporary reprieve. Everybody's dying. Dude, somebody did that the other day, man. They shot our guy right before Kavera could get all the interrogation out of him.
Assisting downed operator.
Look at Lady V. Look at Lady V. She's a lady. Whoa, whoa, whoa. She's a lady. She knows what to do. That's Lady V, bro. She's got this all figured out. I'm gonna catch this guy coming up right there. He's in this room right here. No, he's in the room she's looking at. There it is. Lady V with the clutch! So how do you earn characters? You earn money every game, and then you unlock characters with the points you earn each game, or the points, you earn points each game. Lady V comes through and clutches it for the win! My team was motivated when they saw me fall and break my cankles. They're like, no! Yeah, that's how I like to envision it. Motivation. Motivation. Oh, how did I get 11 deaths in the only 3-round game? Oh. Oh, yeah. I don't want to die, I want to live. That seems like a lot of effort. Meh. Do you like my meh? Oh, that was after this. Oh, that was after sushi, bro. I fell asleep in this chair, dude. I was like this. It was like 4 hours later. I was like, My dad was like throwing peanuts in my mouth, dude. I'm like, my pops is like, I've been throwing peanuts at you for like 5 minutes. Yeah, I was sloshed that night, man. It's true. It was, dude, I was sleeping in World of Tanks in our game. I was in my Waffen Traeger and I hear like, hey! And I look up, dude, like, we're gaming. Oh. Yep. I definitely was. I had tied on a fine one that night. It's alright, I'm gonna take you over to Mongolian barbecue. You shit yourself for 5 days straight. Oh no, Chang'a! No! It's like that one South Park. Do I eat asparagus and cuttlefish or crimp paste? Oh, I see feet! I saw feet. He's got.
Well done. Biohazard container located.
I see the pitter patter of little feet. Yeah, buddy. I'm gonna cut through that wall right there that it's in the background and come dancing through there. I'm gonna be like doing the. Dun-na-na-na. The breach is the other one. Time to make a new door. Take cover. That was reinforced. Ow! He's got a buddy in there! I didn't even see him! Not my face! Yeah. That's right. Yeah, I know I was right, but right. Uh-oh, yeah, this guy's gonna blast through there. He's gonna be like, hey, knock, knock. This man is brave. Nice one, dude. That was some ninja stuff right there. Placing cluster charge.
messing around. Shocking awesome. Oh, interesting.
Which is weird. Because every shot when you're laying down is 100%. They hit you in the shoulder, it counts as a headshot.
Four last up.
Teabag him! Teabag him!
Hostile activity. Neutralize the threat. Down to one friendly.
He had the Mongolian beef. Just because he throws like my sister with a softball doesn't mean anything. He was ready with his shotgun. He was ready with the shotgun. Oh. Heck yeah. They were all inspired by my death. That's debatable, bro.
But he's so weak. He's got no armor.
No, I was talking to Tyler about me not sucking.
He's trying to be nice. It's a straight up vibe.
Yeah. Oh. What? Moobot censored me? Good job, Moobot. Way to be unbiased. Censor us all. Well, it just puts three asterisks up. I can't even think of a three-letter word that would be unacceptable. Yeah, maybe as. Yeah, I don't.
10 seconds left. 5 seconds to insertion. Op 4 drone has located the biohazard container.
Biohazard containers, what you just did in my bathroom over there, dude. You just blew that thing out, dude. It was like, I was like, whoa, I went by there, my eyes started watering. Years ago, I was at this really hoity-toity party. Just hanging with all these rich socialites. Like, fuck, Paris Hilton was there. I mean, it was pretty rad, dude. Helena, all her friends. Really, really big, big party. And I'd been invited by my friend. And they had the upstairs cordoned off. There was a rope that said, no going upstairs. And so immediately, as soon as I could, I moved the rope, went upstairs, saw this bathroom, you know, whatever. Dude, I went in there and blew that thing out, bro. I mean, I douched it. I demolished that bathroom, dude. The owner of the house goes walking up. He goes, what's this rope down for? Then I hear, Chinga! Dude, he's like, who shit in my daughter's bathroom? And I was like, oh, I just saw this guy leave. He was smoking a cigarette and came out of there. I go, he took down the rope, so I walked upstairs. He's like, okay, well, keep an eye out for him. I want his ass kicked. I'm like, I will, sir.
All friendlies were eliminated.
Oh. All right, guys. We'll catch you later, Steve. No worries. Oh, man. That was funny. Yep, yep. I did that another time at a girl's party that was like in high school, bro. And then, dude, she goes, who's going to help us clean the house? And it was like all the hot girls in school. So I was like, I'll help clean the house. It was after the night of the party. And, you know, and so that next day,
Bro, I went in there and blew out. I mean, dude, there were fire coming out of that thing, dude. And she opened the door in front of like 20 hot chicks, like, oh my God, who douched my bathroom? I was like, oh. I was like, I had the cuttlefish and asparagus. Oh. I never met him, but I heard of your exploits many a time from Jay.
Yeah. JR had a friend of his from high school flew down, and she was staying with him for a while. And I would always get pissed at JR. I'm like, dude, fucking put a warning label up or something. 10 seconds to
insertion. Dude, that was... Bro, dude, I dated this vegan chick years ago named Catalina. Oh my God, dude. I'm like, how can a person that doesn't eat meat make that? What are you eating? Oh. Oh my God. Dude, it was like a white bean diet, yeah. Dude. I avenged you. Shot as me. Oh, what's up, DNS? Go easy, guys. Go easy. Oh man. Yeah, that was a good one. I know, poor Lady V. I'm like, here, carry me. Can you carry me a little farther?
Man. Friendly, last operator standing.
I'm glad, Dad. Yeah, I know. It was cracking me up, man. Another time, Dan, I was walking home from school. And I can't remember her name. She was one of the most popular girls in school. Her name is Erica Plano. Erica Plano. I was walking home from school. Shut up. She stopped her Camaro to pick me up. I jumped in the back of the Camaro, tried to be all cool because, you know, she had the top down. So I'm like, yeah. Oh, I ripped it. No, dude. I landed in the back seat. It was like... in the back seat, dude. And, like, all these chicks run out of the car. I was like, oh, it was like 2 years later, I'm at another party, and she goes, hey, you remember that time you, like, shit yourself in the back seat of my car? I'm like, it was a fart. I had the cuttlefish and asparagus. Oh. Another time, take a date out. We're at the movie theater. It's the most quietest part of the movie. It's like, Luke, I am your father type quiet. I mean, the most quietest part. My stomach been hurting all night, and I'm like, all right, I'm going to squeak one out and crop dust these guys behind me. Nobody will know. It was like, loud, dude. Everybody in the theater started laughing, dude. The whole theater heard it, dude. Oh.
We need to protect the biohazard container.
I was in a movie like that one time, and the person was yelling at the screen like we were watching Scream, like, and they're like, run, bitch, run, you're gonna die. No, it was I Know What You Did Last Summer Part 2.
Down to 10 seconds.
Oh. What?
Biohazard container. They will attempt to
moon. So I can only toss one of these gas bombs at a time, right?
One at a time.
Okay, I go. Right, that's the other button. No asparagus and cuttlefish. Oh, you can eat cuttlefish. But I'm sure there's some type of protected species of cuttlefish. It's one of the oldest living beings in the sea. Cuttlefish, they trace them back in the fossil record. 250 million years they go back. Yeah, it is cuttlefish. It's much more simple than the octopus and the squid. A cuttlefish is in the same family. Like a protozoa or amoeba or something. I'm talking about. You can see their shells are still preserved, son. Yes, they do have shells. They take shells from other animals and live in them. I will. Activate. I love Cuttlefish Inc. Oh, he shot me through the face! How did he see me?
There's no bone.
Yeah, and they grab like a conch shell and they live in it. Yes, they do! You don't know then. You're looking at like a moonrite cuttlefish. You are not. You are unlogical. I have been eating cuttlefish for 1,000 years. I know I have. You eat nasty squid shit with asparagus. All right, guys. On that note, me and Moonwreck are going to go fight some cuttlefish. It's been a blast.